Hi, welcome to this video. In this video, we're going to pick up where we stopped last time. In the previous video, we actually ran and compiled our first demo. So if you haven't watched that video, make sure to do so. In this video, we're going to actually edit the content associated with that demo using Napkin, our editor, or by typing some JSON. Before we actually edit any content, it's good to look at the point where your application loads the content, and that is on initialization of your application. So remember the Hello World app? It has an init call, and in that init call, it actually calls resource manager load file, including the name of the file you want to load. And in this case, that's helloworld.json. This file contains all your textures, images, 3D models, entities, components, logic, you name it, for your application to function and run correctly. So we now know which file is actually read by the application on initialization. So let's locate it on disk and edit it. So I'm going to my Explorer here, and I'm going into the demos directory of the net package root, going to Hello World. And in here, you'll find the data directory. And the data directory contains all the assets your application needs, including the helloworld.json file we just referred to. So I can just open this up. I'm using Sublime to edit JSON text. And in here, you'll find all the objects the resource manager spawns on initialization. So you will find, for example, a sphere mesh called the world, a shader. Pretty much everything is in here. Now let's verify that the application actually reads this file on initialization. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start the application from Visual Studio. Here it is. Hi there, welcome to NOP. And I'm going to change the text that we see here. So I'm going to look for hi there, welcome to NOP. There it is. It's the component that actually renders this text to screen. And it has a field to change the text. So I'm going to write something else here. Test, this is a YouTube video. Et voilà. This proves actually two things. It proves that the file is read by the application, but it also proves that any changes you make to this file while the application is running are hotloaded directly into your running application. That means you don't have to recompile your application to make certain changes. For example, in this case, changing the text on screen, but it could also be the position of a button, the IP address of a device, pretty much anything. Instead of writing JSON, you can also use Napkin, our editor, to do that for you. So let's open Napkin. I'm already in the Hello World demo folder. I'm going into the bin directory here, and the bin directory is created when you build your application. And in this case, I will go into the release build of my application, and next to the Hello World executable, you will find Napkin. And Napkin is deployed by our build system next to your executable when you build an application. So let's fire it up. And there we go. Now we just need to load the JSON file we just edited. Same location, Hello World, data, helloworld.json, and voila, Napkin loaded our helloworld.json file. So let's try and change the text again. So I'm going to look for the renderable text component using the filter. Here it is. And here is the text input field. I'm just going to write something else. Test 2. This is the same YouTube video. Press Ctrl S to save. And the app is still running in the background. So let's see if the change is propagated. And there it is. So what this demonstrates is that the application just listens to the JSON file on disk, and any change made to that JSON file, either through using Napkin or by typing in text in your text editor, is directly picked up by the running application. Last thing I want to do in this video is add a new font, and the font that is currently used by the application can be found here. It's montserratlite.otf, and I just want to add a new one. To do that, we have to add a new font resource to our application. And Napkin can do that for us. We just have to select resources, right-click on it, click on create resource and type font. Napkin added a font for us. We can give it a different name if we want, font 2 for example, and point it to the new font on disk. So I'm already in my Hello World directory. I go to data, go to fonts, and select the new font I want to load. Press Ctrl save and nothing happens. And that's because the component that actually draws the text to screen still refers to the first font. So we'll look that one up. Renderable text component, here it is. And point it to the new font we just created. Press Control Save. And there you can see that it actually draws a text now with a new font, but it's really small. So we can change the size property of the font itself. So here it is, font 2. Change the size, let's change it into something bigger, like 64, and there we go. The text is now drawn with a different font than the one it was originally drawn with. That's about it for this video. We've covered a lot of ground, including the creation and editing of resources using Napkin or your favorite text editor. Note that up to this point we haven't written a lot of code, which is a good thing, and also that the entire application has been running live in the background during the complete time of this video, happily accepting all the changes we throw at it. So that's about it. Thanks for watching, and see you at the next one.